What happens if nuclear material is found somewhere it shouldn't be? Where did it come from? How old is it? How did it get there? Law enforcement has many tools to answer these questions, and this is the idea behind the process known as nuclear forensics. One of the most important questions in forensics is knowing when something happened, and this is especially true for seized nuclear materials. Having a working knowledge of the timeline of the production of nuclear material drastically narrows the possibilities of its origin. The concept, called age dating, involves constraining how old a nuclear material is. There are many variations of age dating in science. Biologists age date trees from counting their rings. Geologists age date rocks by counting atoms produced by radioactive decay over long timescales. And nuclear forensics experts age date nuclear materials by counting atoms from radioactive decay over the last century. To do this, scientists turn to the periodic table for help. Many elements, such as potassium, carbon, uranium, plutonium, and americium, have radioactive isotopes useful for age dating. The best age dating system to use simply depends on the material you are measuring. Because radioactivity behaves in a very predictable way over known timescales, radioactive isotopes are essentially clocks that record interesting events in the sample they are in. When one element decays to another, these are called the parent and the daughter isotopes, respectively. The older the sample, the more parent isotopes have turned into daughter isotopes, so the amount of each changes predictably over time. To use an isotope system like this to tell time, scientists must first chemically separate and purify the parent and daughter isotopes from each other. The amount of each isotope must then be determined using specialized instruments. Most commonly, mass spectrometers are used to precisely measure how much parent and daughter isotopes are present, allowing scientists to calculate the radioactive decay in the sample and, in turn, when something happened to the sample. Depending on what type of nuclear material a sample is made from, many different age dating clocks can be applied. For instance, if a sample is made from primarily uranium, scientists look at how much uranium has decayed to form its various daughter isotopes, such as thorium, protactinium, radium, etc. Since the age of a sample can potentially tell you where this material comes from, how it was produced, or what its intended use was, age dating is an extremely useful tool in the nuclear security toolbox that helps experts and law enforcement keep the world safe from nuclear threats.